We are here in Monte St, the 20th time now. It's the anniversary, so 20 years of Monte St. This year they have the World Championships again, mountain bike and trial. We got everything together. We had a few issues with the wheels because Windham was very rough on equipment, so we had to swap a few rims and getting prepared. Sandy is busy with that now. But we got all the parts that we need for the race, so we are 100% ready for the race tomorrow, and I'm pretty sure it's gonna go well.
The course usually is all mud and it's pretty slow in general just because it's more power sapping. The ground is usually pretty spongy. Now it's super hard pack and instead of mud we have loose sand. So it's still technical, but it's a different type of technical. And the forecast for this weekend is for Hurricane Earl to hit here sometime tomorrow possibly. So we could go from this dry hard pack dust to boggy mud overnight, but we'll have to wait and see for the morning. Up to this point, with all the dust and dry conditions, we've been running the Renegator tires. They're a lower knob, faster rolling tire, and if it gets muddy, we'll be back on the mud tires and lower pressure. The conditions will slow down, and so we'll just really have to wait and see tomorrow what the weather brings.
To me, the course feels it's a bit more flowy. They're made some corners a bit wider, so you can take a little more speed into it, but it got rougher because world champs, there's so many guys training on that course and lots of roots are sticking out, and I still feel like I have a very smooth ride. The bike feels like a part of my body at the moment, and that's also a good indication of having a good shape mentally, being ready, and I'm definitely fired up. The dust got more into a little bit of a sand, so it almost feels better. There were still some slippy roots out there which didn't dry out. I hope they don't get splashed tomorrow again. The weather forecast is pretty bad, but you never know. Here in Monte St, weather predictions are not very reliable.
What do you think, Burry? Checking out those new tires.
Yeah, I tried them out yesterday, like I said, in anticipation of the rain, and the rain's come through, and I think it's going to be pretty slippery. We raced here last year in the mud and it was quite tough, and it'd be good to try these tires in the mud for the first time. They worked good yesterday. They've got really good rolling resistance, good spacing, and we'll see how they hook up and how they clear today.
And then this is
most of the race I was at the front or near the front. There was a bunch of guys making mistakes, crashing, getting flat tires, and I just kind of decided, you know, it was a long race and it was going to be towards the end where it was going to be decided, and I just kind of rode my own pace. So Mita got up there with us, you know, with Yaroslav as well, and yeah, towards the end I just had to let those guys go with, I think, two laps to go. The 29er Hata I'm riding now has just been getting better every week. You know, the team's been working on it so hard, and it's great to be able to give a good result back to the team. I got a gold last year at the U23, being the world champion, and that was a major stepping stone in my career. And to be able to medal the first year in Elite is a dream come true, and you know, from here on I can just build. At 22 years of age, I'm sure I've still got a few world championships in me, and you know, from now on I'll definitely be hunting for that elusive gold medal.
Had a good start, although there was a start crash, but Absaloh and Jose and myself, we just could go around and started chasing. And yeah, we had good speed, just catching up the leaders. It was lap one after two big, big start loops. I could feel going through the start-finish line on the asphalt, I'm having a flat tire here, that's not the open brain system. And yeah, that was just a few seconds after the tech zone. So I ended up running forever and yeah, all the way in the single trail. And then I changed my rear wheel, had a good tire on again, and but yeah, 7 minutes down and the race was completely gone. Then also my legs were gone, my head was gone, and I started crashing. I really wanted to win, or at least top three, after the results last week, and that was all possible. But yeah, I was with lots of other guys in the same boat. I mean, Nino had two flat tires, Absalom had a flat tire, so yeah. But congrats to Burry, that was a good ride.
Sure, I had a great start today and was probably in the top 10 on the first lap, faded back to around 15th and stayed there for the majority of the race. Going into the last lap, I dropped to maybe 17th, and then in the last half lap, I lost like 5 places. So it was a pretty solid race, not great, but it was solid. And then at the end, I just kind of cracked and even so, I'm a little disappointed, but you know, I gave it my all and didn't have anything left, so I gotta be happy about that.
Yeah, I go back home now, and it'll be great to be able to enjoy the medal at home. It's the first medal for South Africa in Elite Cross Country Race, and I'm sure that it will be quite a big deal at home, and I'm really looking forward to sharing it with my friends and family.